This lesson is about the running processes. Some are demons, some are your processes, and some are the operating system itself, but there are always lots of processes running. The utility that lists the running processes for you is named PS, which is an acronym for Process Status. It has more command line options than a program should be allowed to have. I'll be showing you how some of them work, but if you enter the command without any options, you get this. This gives you a brief look at the processes associated directly with your login. In this case, it's the Bash shell and the PS process itself. The first column is labeled PID, which is the process ID number. Every process has one, and it is unique in the system. No two running processes can have the same PID. The PID is automatically assigned whenever a process starts running, and they're assigned in order. The first process is given the number 1, the second the number 2, and so on. As you can see, the PID numbers for these two processes is quite large. Now, this number doesn't just grow forever. It gets to 32K or thereabouts and starts over at the beginning. However, care is taken that no PID number is ever awarded to a program if that number is already awarded to a running program. When a collision happens, that number is skipped and the next one's used. Why stop at 32K, you may well ask? Well, that's because it's the largest number that will fit into 16 bits, and Unix was originally developed on a 16-bit machine. The numbering system has been working just fine all these years, so nobody's found a reason to change it. The second column is the name of the device node of the terminal to which this process is attached. The PTS terminals are the device nodes of the pseudo terminals, of which this is one because it's an X-window terminal. The time column displays the amount of CPU time that the process has consumed since it started running. As you can see, neither of these processes has consumed a full second as yet. Finally, the CMD column contains the name of the running command itself. Some processes, such as the operating system and some daemons, are not associated with a terminal. It's possible to list all the processes that have no terminals associated with them by using the X option. Not only can you see more processes, but you can also see a slight difference in the format of the data presented. A question mark in the TTY column indicates that the process is not associated with a terminal. A new column named STAT shows the current status of the program at the moment the snapshot was taken. The letter S indicates that a process is sleeping, and the letter R means that it's running. Other statuses exist. For example, the letter D indicates that a process is in an uninterruptible sleep, usually indicating it's waiting for disk input or output. The letter T will show up on a process that has been halted by a debugger, and Z is for zombie. We'll be getting into orphans and zombies in the next lesson. The CMD column is now named Command, and it not only shows the program being run, but it also shows the arguments that were passed to it to start it running. Now you can see some programs that have used a bit of CPU time since they started running. These are all GNOME utilities. For example, PID 3556 is the GNOME screen manager, and 3557 is a screensaver. And you can see there are bash shells attached to different virtual terminals, which means there are other windows like this one open somewhere.